हेलो एवरीवन,
सो यू कैन सी दिस वीडियो इज हेल्पफुल फॉर दोज पीपल हु आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम्स. वीडियो आई एम गोना टॉक अबाउट वन वर्ड विच डिनोट्स द स्टडी ऑफ दैट साइंस और आर्ट, एंड आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अ लिटिल बिट अबाउट इट सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ इज गोइंग टू बी रिलेवेंट टू योर स्टडीज. सो देर आर 64 स्लाइड्स विच आई एम गोइंग टू शेयर टू यू. लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस. होप दिस विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू. So, first, I want to talk about is acoustics. It's a study of sound. Basically, study is about the technical sort of sounds which are very popular right now in a lot of Bollywood movies or a lot of DJ places. If you see that study of that sound is called acoustics. Now, coming to aeronautics. So, when I have seen a lot of people say aeronautics is study of aeroplane, sometimes flight. So no, actually aeronautics is the study of science of art of flight. So it's very tricky question. Sometimes I do have also faced this in my competitive exams. So aeronautics is something which belongs to the study of science of art of flight. So you can clear your confusion as well. Now aesthetics. So aesthetics is nothing but which is very attractive to eye, and this is the study of philosophy of fine arts. So fine arts like crafting, painting, there are a lot of crafts. So you I cannot wooden crafts, and then there are a lot of moldings. This all comes in aesthetics. Agronomy. So agronomy is the basically study of science of soil management and the production of field crops. So soil management, as in there are 4 to 5 type of soils. So managing the soil in that geographical area and production of field crops, that study comes under agronomy. After that, I'm going to speak about alchemy. Alchemy is a chemistry in ancient times. So you have heard about alchemist and all that. So this is the study which people used to do in ancient times, as in very back to time like Latin or Greek time. So that time the study, and you can also see the periodic table over there that time. So alchemist is something that chemistry has to do with the ancient times. Bibliography. So especially people who are doing projects in their college and all that. So many of your project will be, at the end you would have been written bibliography. So bibliography is nothing but where you put down all the history of books from where you have taken reference. So bibliography is the study of history of a list of books on a subject. So I hope I am able to make you understand that. Like if you are going to make let's say a project on computer science, so computer science generation. So if you are taking any reference to, let's say, Wikipedia or some book you have bought. So in last, when you make the project, in the last you write bibliography, you have taken that reference from this. There's nothing but the study of history of the list of books on that subject. So it differs to all the subject and applies on all the references. Now next is anatomy. Anatomy is basically the science dealing with the structure of animal, plants or human body. So if you are referring it to a human, you will say human anatomy. If you are referring it to animal, you will say animal anatomy. If you are telling about the plant, then you will say plant anatomy. So anatomy is basically basically the study of structure, and you can associate with either plant, animal or human. Anthropology. So anthropology is nothing but the study of the origin, physical and the culture development of a mankind. So mankind, as in basically we study about the mankind in anthropology. So students who are have a anthropology background would be knowing that you study about marriages, caste and what sort of work they used to do, how the civilization has worked on for that human specifically area. So anthropology is the study of that kind of culture development of that specific area. This is arboriculture. This is cultivation of trees and vegetables. This is very common nowadays, very in practice because of the harmful effects of you have must have a greenhouse effect, and there are a lot of effects. So nowadays, it's very hot topics to be asked on the question, on the examination. Astrology, India is one of the country where astrology has been always very strong. Many of the first proof of astrology has come from India. So astrology is nothing but the study of heavenly body, cosmo body. You study about the planets and their movement, and then you predict on them how it's going to work for the specific planet or people associated with that specific planet. So if I have to name it, I remember Aryabhatta was a great astrologer, and he was also a mathematician. So you can relate that it's a sort of a science of and you should be very proud that it has originated in India. Now, bacteriology is the study of bacteria, very specific, very simple. Botany, the study of plants. Many of you will be a student of botany. Calligraphy. Calligraphy is the art of beautiful handwriting, and that handwriting can be in any language, not specific to English. You have heard, seen that Taj Mahal. If you have seen that, there is a beautiful calligraphy done in the inner walls of Taj Mahal. And Akbar's wife Jodha was very good in calligraphy. What else reference I can give that? Steve Jobs was a very interested in calligraphy, and he also mentioned in his speech that he has designed it in his Macintosh computers. So calligraphy is a study of art of beautiful handwriting. Ceramics. Ceramics is pottery, art and technology of making objects from clay. So ceramic is, now some of people would be asking how aesthetics is different from ceramics. So aesthetic is something sort of two dimension, not three dimension, and ceramic and pottery are three dimension. You're looking at touch and feel, you're making with your hands, and you know. So ceramics and pottery is the art and technology of making objects from clay. Chronobiology. Chrono means the time, biology means study of life. So basically, putting this two together, it would be study of duration of life. So what you do, how a life like moment or goals in the all specific time is that study of that time is called chronobiology. Means like what you have done since 6 o'clock to evening 6 o'clock, that is chronobiology. Excuse me. Chronology. Chronology are, again, it's a science of arranging time in period, dates and historical order. So it can, you have to, if you are studying about history or you're studying about anything where time intervals are there, like Darwin theory, you can see chronology sort of how it happened, or you can take references of history books where there's a very specific position of time, because they're going to tell you all the pre-dynasty and all kingdom. And so chronology in a way related to history and a lot of other subjects, because if you say computer science, first generation, second, it's nothing but a chronology. Over a period of time, something has changed. So chronology is basically the study of arranging time and period and asserting dates and historical order in the past event. Chromatic is the art of making fireworks, and nowadays very popular, giving the demand, how especially in India, how the festivals and all that. So it's one of the important word, I think, for your examination. Cosmogony, the science of the nature of heavenly body. So again, cosmology, cosmogony, and then astrology is one and the same, slightly different. See, the science of the nature of heavenly body is cosmogony. Then if you study about a science that describe and map the main feature of the universe, that is cosmography. So is, if you can understand that cosmo means heavenly bodies or body which are out of earth or in on space areas and all, so you can easily make out graphy means will be geographic, chrono means it will be nature. So you can make out other words also. Cosmology, as I have covered it, the science of the nature of origin of history of the universe. Cryogenetics. Okay, this is something which is we are still working on it as a humankind, and it's something new. The science of dealing with the production and control and application of very slow temperatures. So actually, as you can see in photos, is still under the science has one of the newest version of science which has come on board, and this is a study of dealing with the production and control and the application of very slow temperatures. Skipper, the art of secret handwriting. So writings. So earlier in ancient time, it was very important that messages should be coded and decoded. So that's how the art of secret writings has come on. Now also some of the secret services use this for their purpose. So this is actually the art of secret writing. And of course, there is no pattern of it. Everybody have their own pattern. You have to code and decode according to specific scenario. Cytology, again, very common, the study of cells, especially their formation, structure, and function. Dactylography, okay, the study of fingerprints for the purpose of identification. So this is something which come into biometric sort of the identification, which has recently launched in India as well. Initially also there was very importance of the study, and this actually the study of fingerprint, they are specialists who are expert on this subject, and they generally work for government organization and all that. Dactylology. So the technique of communication by sign made with fingers, it's generally used by deaf. So we have probably, if you have seen, some of you people have seen that national TV, DD1 or TV news channel, something would be seeing a woman on site will be making this sign for deaf people. So actually the people who cannot hear it use this to communicate to other, and this very much in use, and from centuries had been used study. Demography. The study of human population with the help of records of the number of birth and deaths. So demography is nothing but how would I say that? See, if we say that India is one of the youngest country in the world, how do we say it? Because 65% of the population is under 35. So this demographic data which we have got, and the study and the analyzing we have got, this is what demography say. So it's the study of human population with the help of records, number of births and deaths. So it's demography. Ecology is the study of relation of animal and plants to the surrounding animal, animate and inanimate. So it's very basic. Anatomology, study of insects. Epigraphy, the study of inscription. Inscription is was very, very vital part in Indian history. If you say very ancient, maybe Stone Age history or Vedical history, it was very popular. And inscription are still, you know, if you dig, still I hear that archaeologists have dig somewhere and got this inscription and all that. So the study of inscription is called, it's very, actually the language is used, a very ancient time language. So nobody, like you have, need to have expertise on this subject. Anthology, the study of human race. So you might be knowing there are a lot of, you know, I think if I remember to correctly, 7 to 8 type of races in the world. Now, as the human is growing up, and now I'm getting mixed races everywhere. So the study of human race, from where that that has come out. Like if you say I'm African, or I'm Asian or Indo-Aryan or something, Aryans and all that. These are human races, nothing but. Now if you see mixed races nowadays, people are getting married, going abroad. So this whole study of human races is come under anthology. Ethology, study of animal behavior. Etymology, the study of origin and history of words. So this is very interesting, because every word has come out from somewhere. Like we say that many of English words have come from Sanskrit, and then we say that this study, this word has taken from Latin or Greek. So that sort of origin and history of that word and how it got compiled up. It's very interesting, and that study is coming to under entomology. Eugenics. So the study of production or better offspring by careful selection of parents. So nowadays, so to say that production, like lot of say like genetic engineering has been very advanced, to be put in very precise way. So the study of production and better offspring by careful selection of parents sort of comes under that. So you're getting best out of best. That's what it means. Ergonomy, the study of effect of environment on workers. So nowadays many big giants, you know, MNCs, they like to know about how they are treating their employees and how their workers are working, especially if those kind of companies where life is at risk on work, like if you're working in oil and gas or chemical or sort of say on ships, places where human life is has to be very safeguard, because the product they are using or the process they are using can be harmful. So in that sort of especially that sort of companies and that sort of organization, whether private or government, do the studies to know, understand what kind of environment and what kind of that effect is going on that worker. So they say popular nowadays. Genealogy is the study of family ancestry and history. It's a very common way. People say sometimes say that we have come from this area. Especially if you ask your parents or your grandmother, they will tell you about the family history. So see, I'm not telling about mother, grandmother, doesn't mean in a very generic way. See, if the genealogists, what they do, they took like many of genealogists have heard that they want to know that where Jesus Christ or background of something, you know, a very famous name or very famous, they want to know that what kind of background from where they have come and all that. So that how you study the family ancestry and history. So there are a lot of places where they keep this kind of records for references, future references, so they can have, you know, understanding of that how it has been locomotive from one place to another. So genealogy is study of family ancestries and histories. Genetics, very basic, and everybody knows about the study of biology dealing with the phenomenon of heredity and laws governing it. Geology, okay, so geology is very special because I have special affection for this. It's the study of physical history of the earth. Gymnastics, the art of performing of acrobatic beats, very common nowadays. One of the one of the popular gymnastics which I know is Tiger Shroff. Heliotherapy, the sun cure. So as science is growing, you can understand what are the healing powers of sun and a lot of things which are right now. You have heard that yoga and sort of hot yoga and this yoga, hatha yoga, ashta yoga. There's one thing called heliotherapy, something like that, which tells you about the sun cure. As you know, sun has a lot of inbuilt capacities, like it can heal in some way. I am not expert on this, but let me provide you example of it. Like you must have heard about the sun rays have vitamin D. So this sort of people who are have deficiency of it, people say that go to sun and at least not like hot sun or something like that, but have at least some never be in house something. So sort of sun cure is something attached to that. The expert would be knowing in what temperature and what kind of thing, what how it's going to help you out. But there's something which is going to, I think in future will be a very very fast moving sort of curing way. Histology, the study of tissues, very common. Horticulture, the cultivation of flower, fruit, vegetables, ornament plants, which is very popular nowadays. Hybriding is very popular, mutation is very popular, so horticulture is very popular. Hydropathy, the treatment of disease by internal and external use of power. So I cannot comment on this because I have no, not much of an idea about this. But yeah, so this happens. Hagiology, the study of lives of saints. So you know, it's something related to, of course, theology. Theology you might be knowing is the study of religion. Lives of saints. Iconography, the study of symbolic representation. And now it is very popular because of thanks to the, you know, lot of apps which have come for chatting options. So the study of iconography, the study of symbolic representations. Jurisprudence, the science of law. How the law have made, how it's gonna help the citizen, how, why it has been molded in that way. That all explanation come inside that. Lexicography, the writing or compiling of dictionaries. Numismatics, the study of coins and metals. I have heard about a lot of friends who say that they like to, you know, collect coins and old coins and all that. So the study of coins and metal, that's a thing. It's very ancient and people do it. Ornithology, study of birds. Odontology, the scientific study of this. Orthoepy, the study of correct pronunciation. Very good. So orthoepy, the study of correct pronunciation. So let's start with pedagogy, which is the art of method of teaching. Like you know, there are a lot of how would I put it? See, if you remember at when we were children, there would be some different type mode of you know, teaching of education, teaching methods. And now when this you know generation are going up, like more practical approaches, more video oriented classes. I've also seen that in recent time, maybe you know, when I was doing my management studies, I remember we were only allowed to keep our laptops while studying. So the mode of education, the mode of teaching is evolving. So that all art of method of teaching comes under this. Petrology is the study of rock crust. I've studied this. there are basically three types of rocks. So you understand the study of rocks and crust. On petrology. Crust, why I say? Because earth is, you know, divided in crust, and crust is the upper part where the rocks are available. Philately, the collection and study of postage and revenue stamps. A lot of people do that. See, what happens if people are not aware of it? Let me explain it to you. In some special occasion, if you have seen that some postage. Special postage will be coming up. Especially, it was in recent time. I haven't heard it, but I remember when I was young. On special, if someone has done that, like Milkha Singh, when he was done something good with India, was proud of India, made some postage about it. Then there was a postage of Indira Gandhi. So in special occasion, India makes some stamp to celebrate that occasion. So collection of that postage and revenue stamp is called that study philately. Philology, the study of written records and their authenticity. Authenticity as in like how authentic they are, whether they are the right records, written records, or you know, fake records. The study of written records and their authenticity is done through philology. Phonetics, the study of speech sound production, transmission, reception. So if you see some like if you go to some gathering or something, you will see people with mic will say alpha, and they will hello check, they will do so this sort of thing. How you going to study the speech sound, whose voice is clear, tone is right. So this all thing comes in this study, production, transmission, and reception. How it has been produced, how it has been transmit as it was the sound, and how it has been recepted. How the people have reception, recepted it. So that all comes in phonetics. Physiognomy, the study of human face. So obviously every face is different, and as we have evolved from one cell to you, if you have studied Darwin theory, you know, you'd be knowing how evolution has happened. So the study of human face is very important to understand you know, mutation and how it works. So I have seen, also given some pictures, that how you know, the human face has been relevant to some sort of animals. So this all study comes in physiognomy. That again, physio comes with a physical structure, and gonomy is a study. Paleography, study of ancient writing. So it's very popular. Of course, right now also there are a lot of ancient handwriting which is still in use. Like one of those I remember is Sanskrit, Tamil, then there is Greek, Latin. Rhetoric, the art of elegant speech or writing. Again, very important. Sericulture, the raising of silkworms and of the production of raw silk. I think the spelling is wrong though. Please excuse me for that. So sericulture is the raising of silkworm and their production of raw silk. Seismology, the study of earthquakes and the phenomena associated with earthquakes. As a geologist, I can tell you what, why it happens, but that's not about it right now. But I can tell you a lot of things which are involved in seismology, and it's very important if you take interest of it. Speleology, the study of caves. Obviously, the Stone Age is all about caves, and caves tell you about, a lot about civilization. So this is very relevant to the archaeologist. Telepathy, communication between mind with some means other than sensory perception. Very commonly used, and yeah. Zoology, the study of human life. So that is about, we have